So define a new development directory. Any way in your batch development directory or any way create one development directory, go to src and classes. We want to develop a Java program which has to print this format, which has to print this pattern. What is there in this pattern? Totally 5 rows are there. First observe, then you can develop. Totally 5 rows are there. Every row containing 5 elements. Every row containing 5 objects, 5 entities. Every entity is a star model. You can consider like a 5 rows and 5 columns. With respect to objects, it's a perfect square. 5 rows, each row containing 5 columns. Each row containing 5 columns. For rows purpose, we can design one for loop. Let that for loop iterating 5 times. For rows purpose, one for loop with 5 time iteration. For every row, constant number of columns, constant number of columns. These columns can be produced through one inner for loop that also iterating 5 times. Outer for loop for the rows purpose, inner for loop for columns purpose. Outer for loop 5 times, inner for loop also 5 times. In the inner for loop, after printing a star, don't go to the next line. Print one more star in the same line. Print one more star in the same line. Likewise, 5 stars. After printing 5 stars, then only you have to go to the new line. We have already seen print method and println method. So here, print method should be used to print 5 stars. After printing 5 stars, then only println method it has to go to the next line. Now you can see the program, very simple. Compose everybody A dot Java. Observe print method usage, println method, where we are using print method, where we are using println method. Please try to analyze 3-4 iterations so that you can clearly understand. For I value 1, J value 1, J value 2, J value 3, J value 4 and 5. We are using print method only. 5 times starts are printing in the same line. After inner for loop, there is a println to produce the new line. For I value 1, 5 starts and then going to the new line. For I value 2, now cursor is in the second line. The same second line, J value 1, 1 star, J value 2, 1 more star, J value 3, 1 more star. In the same second line, 5 stars are printing. Afterwards, new line, println. It's going to the third line. For I value 2, second line, 5 stars, then going to the third line.
Prime value 3.
Again,
J is starting from 1. Cursor is at third line. In the third line, 5 stars. Then going to the fourth line. Prime value 4. Again, inner for loop 5 times. In the fourth line, 5 stars. Then printing a new line. Cursor going to the fifth line. Prime value 5. Inner for loop. 5 stars are printing in the 5th line, then going to the 6th line. Whenever I value 6, coming away. Whenever I value 6, coming away. If you know this one, you can understand almost 90% of patterns, how you can develop. 90% of patterns are having a base code, outer for loop, inner for loop, inside a inner for loop, print method, after finishing inner for loop, println method. If you know this one properly, you can address any kind of display patterns examples. Very simple way of development. Please go through one more time. Outer for loop for rows purpose, inner for loop for columns purpose. In every row, constant number of columns are there. That is why inner for loop is used for columns for every row. After completely inner for loop execution got over, then println to bring the cursor to the next line. Similar kind of pattern, but objects are changing. Similar type of pattern, objects are changing. So try to develop by yourself. I'll give 5-10 minutes time. It's very simple. Copy the previous program. Do the modification wherever it is required.
Then everybody, it's not difficult at all. Just to print I rather than printing a star under double quotes. In the previous program, we were printing a star under double quotes. For the first row, I value 1. For J value 1, printing 1. For J value 2, printing 1. For J value 3, 4, 5, printing 1. Then new line, going to the next iteration. Next iteration, that is for next row, I value 2. For I value 2, J value 1, 2 is printing. J value 2, 2 is printing. J value 3, 2 is printing. J value 4, 2 is printing. J value 5, 2 is printing. Then new line. In the next iteration, that is for next row, I value 3. For I value 3, inner for loop, iterating 5 times. 3 is printing 5 times in the same line. Print method. It's not a println, it's print method. After printing 3 5 times, then println. Going to the next iteration. Very simple. First row, 5 ones. Second row, 5 twos, 5 threes, 5 fours, 5 fives. It's very simple. Print method using I. For the first row, I value 1. Second row, I value 2. Compile and run. Move to the next program. Then everybody, what we supposed to print under print method? J. Print J. Every row content is same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No matter I value 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5, row content is same. J starting from 1, going till to the 5.
print the J, you will be getting same output. Straightforward, very simple. Move to the next one. Uppercase alphabets, first row all columns same, second row all columns same, third row all columns same, fourth row, fifth row. Column wise objects are not changing, same. You can use a for loop with alphabets also. Internally it will be using alphabet itself.
No water facility here. We'll arrange at least by tomorrow.
Understood, everybody? In place of int I, we are using char I. While going for I plus plus, it is going to the B. In the first row, I value A. While going for I plus plus, automatically it is going to the B. Internally, it is using ASCII code character to increment. ASCII code of a character to increment. You don't require to worry about all the things. Straight away you can go for I plus plus. Every character internally having a unique ASCII code. That ASCII code will increment. For the incremented value, whatever character is there, that character will be assigned to I.
will become 6.
Initially, I value A. While going for I++, for A, whatever ASCII code integer value is there, that is incremented. For the incremented value, whatever character is there, that is assigned to I. I less than or equal to E. If column wise modification is not there, then straight away print I. If column wise modification is there, then only you have to check whether J or something else. Here, in a particular row, all the columns are same. In a particular row, all the columns are same. That is why print I. Go to the next one. Try to develop by yourself. Done, everybody? Please check it out. In a particular row, if something is changing column wise, most probably J might be suitable, but still depending on the pattern. So here it's a very simple pattern, very simple pattern. In every row, columns are changing, but content is same while considering two rows or three rows or five rows. You can start inner for loop, j is equal to a, j less than or equal to e, then print j. For the first row I value 1, j will be a, in the next iteration b, then c, then d, then e. In the same row, a to e. Then going to the next row, in the next row again it is starting with a. A to E. Very simple. Check it out, 5 to 1. A simple observation here, columns are not changing. If columns are not changing, most probably I value you can print. But what is the starting, what is the ending that you have to understand? Start I value with 5. Every time you can decrement, look for greater than or equal to 1. Outer for loop, starting I value with 5, every time decrement and go for greater than or equal to 1, print I straight away. How many of you done? Please raise your hands. Understood everybody? Come to the next one. Thank you. In every row, columns are changing, but row content is same, columns are varying every time 5 to 1. You can start I value from 1 to 5, J value 5 to 1, every time increment the J and print the J. I value 1, J value 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then new line. I value 2, J value 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then new line. I value 3, J value 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then new line. Straightforward. Come to the next two ones. All the columns in a particular row is same. All the columns in a particular row is the same.
Try to print I.
For the first row, E means I should start with the E. In the second row, D means I should be decremented. I should be decremented.
Come to the next one. Columns are changing, but every row having a same content. Row wise content is same, column wise changing. There is a particular pattern like a decrementing. You can go for J starting with E, every time decrementing, going till to A. J starting with E, every time it is decrementing. So already we have seen. Develop a new development directory. First analyze, then you can develop. First row containing 1 star, second row containing 2 stars, third row 3 stars, fourth row 4 stars. Totally 5 rows, first row only 1, I value 1, 1 star. Second row, I value 2, 2 stars, third row, I value 3, 3 stars. Fourth row, I value 4, 4 stars. Fifth row, I value 5, 5 stars. What you can do is, in the inner for loop, int j is equal to 1, j less than or equal to I, star. J less than or equal to I. If I value 1, inner for loop executes only one time. If I value 2, inner for loop executes 2 times. J less than or equal to I. First row, I value 1. 1 star. J value 1. In the second row, I value 2, 2 stars. J value 1 and 2. In the third row, I value 3, 3 stars. J value should be 1, 2, 3. Fourth row. I value 4, 4 stars. J should be 1, 2, 3, 4. Simple. This is a simple triangle pattern.
Earlier we were keeping j less than or equal to 5. Every row containing same number of columns. Now, row containing number of columns based on row count. If row count is 1, 1 column only. If row count is 2, 2 columns. Row count is 3, 3 columns. Row count is 4, 4 columns. That is why inner for loop, how many number of times it has to iterate, that is purely based on row count. If row number is a 4, 4 times inner for loop will be iterating. If row count is a 5, inner for loop iterating 5 times. This is the simplest triangle among all. Very simple triangle. Same pattern, only elements are changing. What we supposed to do? In the same pattern, print I. In the same pattern. J less than or equal to I only. Print I. In the first row, I value 1. Inner for loop iterating only one time, we are getting a 1. In the second row, I value 2. Inner for loop is printing 2 times. We are printing 2 and 2. We are printing 2 and 2. I value 3. Inner for loop is executing 3 times. 3 times. All 3 times we are printing I. 3 times 3. Next row, 4 times 4. Next row, 5 times 5. Simple. In this pattern, you have to understand how many columns in a particular row, how we can produce a dynamic incrementing number of columns. Columns are not fixed for every row. Columns are incrementing. How incrementing? Based on the row count, based on the row number. That is why J less than or equal to I. J less than or equal to I. Copy the same.
It's a straightforward, same pattern, you have to print it J. Pattern is same, no need of modifying. Outer for loop header, inner for loop header, only printing element is changing, that is J. Printing element is changing, that is J.
Thank you.
Straightforward. Let I starting with A, ending with E. Print I in the inner for loop. Inner for loop. I. Printing I. J less than or equal to I. J less than or equal to I. Same pattern. Only display element is changing. Pattern is same. Inner for loop J is equal to A. J less than or equal to 5. J is equal to A. J less than or equal to I. Same program Q. Which one is changed?
It changes.
For 14, huh? What will be the output?
Printing J. Guys, thank you.
So what you have to do now? It's entirely a different pattern. I'll not be explaining you. No solution also will be provided. Take 10 minutes time, everybody. Try to develop by yourself. Thank you.
I'm
Done, everybody? How many of you done? Still there are some odd men outs. Every row, one star is incrementing. For every row, I is incrementing. So, I should be the negative side. In every row, one star is decrementing. For every row, I is incrementing. So, keep I at the negative side. 6 minus I. If total number of rows are 5, then j less than or equal to 6 minus I. If total rows are 10, then j less than or equal to 11 minus I. If I value 1, then j value 1 to 6 minus 1, that is 5. J value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 stars are printed. If I value 2, then J value 1 onwards, 4 minus 2. Sorry, 6 minus 2, that is 4. 4 stars. If I value 3, J maximum value 6 minus 3, that is 3. If I value 4, J maximum value 6 minus 4, that is 2. If I value 5, J maximum value 6 minus 5, that is 1. This is second type of the triangle. This is also very simple. Very simple. Only the condition how many inner iterations are allowing for a particular row. It is purely based on I. While I is incrementing, inner loop iterations are decrementing. While I is incrementing, inner loop iterations are decrementing. If I value 1, inner loop 5 times. If I value 2, inner loop 4 times. If I value 3, inner loop 3 times. If I value 4, inner loop 2 times. If I value 5, inner loop 1 time. Number of stars are keep decrementing as I is moving. I is 1 in the first row, I is 2 in the second row. I keep incrementing, number of stars are decrementing. That is why I should be in the negative side.
J less than or equal to 6 minus I. If I value 1, J value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I value 2, J value 1, 2, 3, 4. If I value 3, J value 1, 2, 3. If I value 4, J value 1, 2. If I value 5, then J value 1. 6 minus I is under expression of inner formula. Pattern is same. Straightforward. What we suppose to print in the inner for loop? I value. Pattern is saying, instead of printing star, print I. Simple pattern.
same pattern, j less than or equal to 6 minus I, instead of printing star, print I.
Go to 20.
In every row, column values are same. If column values are same, then try to print something related to I. Here 6 minus I, first row I value 1, we have to print 5. 6 minus 1, that is 5. The second row I value 2. 6 minus 2, that is 4. Come to the next one. Pattern is same, only display elements are changing. Pattern is same. Pattern is same, display elements are changing. Done, everybody. What we supposed to print in the inner clock? Check. Straight forward. Same pattern. Display element is J.
Thank you.
Earlier it was 6 minus I. 6 was nothing but 1 plus 5. Here, A plus E minus I. In place of 6 minus I, give A plus E minus I. 6 was nothing but 1 plus 5. 1 is starting number. 5 is A. Total number of rows. Very similar to that, A plus E minus I. It will be using ASCII code internally. A ASCII code plus E ASCII code minus I. Whatever value is there for I, for that whatever ASCII code. If I value is A. A ASCII code. If I value is a B, B ASCII code. If I value C, C ASCII code. I already showed how to print the ASCII code. You can just go through what is the ASCII code for A, B, C. You can use the same. Earlier it was 1 plus 5 minus 6. Now it is A plus E minus 6. 1 plus 5 minus I earlier. Now it is A plus E minus I. You can just calculate through ASCII code values. In every row printing I, how many number of columns in a particular row? That is, pattern is same, but now we are using characters, not the integers. Earlier it was 6 minus I, now it is A plus E minus I. 6 was 1 plus 5 minus I, now here A plus E minus I. A simple program to print the ASCII code values. For character A, whatever ASCII code is there, that is assigning to I. Now you can check it out. I plus J minus ASCII code of I. Now you can go back to the previous program. You can analyze what represents A plus E minus I. J less than or equal to A plus E minus I. It is using ASCII code of A, ASCII code of E, ASCII code of minus I character value. Come back to the previous program, try to identify J less than or equal to A plus E minus I. This I can be A or can be B or can be C, D, E. Check it out, 19. Thank you.
Very difficult to do.
Same pattern, display value is J. Come to the next one.
It's very simple, same pattern. Display value changing. Starting J value with 5. Every time J decrementing. J is greater than or equal to 1. Sorry, J is greater than or equal to I. Every time J starting with 5 and J greater than or equal to I, J minus minus. Only calculations, ASCII code values, come to the next one. Thank you.
It's a straightforward. This is little lengthy, the pattern also. Two patterns required to club one pattern in one program. You will come to know this later. So prepare all these examples. We'll see continuation in the next class. So far we have seen simple patterns, very simple patterns.